In this screencast, we're dealing with a couple of reactions that are occurring in a CSTR, and we're going to need to do material balances that involve dealing with species that are participating in multiple reactions. And in this case, we have a reaction of component A with B to produce two compounds, D and E. B is actually the solvent, and so it's present at much higher concentration than A. And so as we'll see, we'll be able to use that to simplify the problem. And in part A, we're asked to determine the volume of the reactor. What we see is that we're given information on the conversion of A in this reaction system. And A is only participating in the first reaction, so in a single reaction. And so since we know how much A is converted, and furthermore, we know the reaction kinetics associated with the reaction through which A is converted, then we can determine the size of the reactor. We can determine the volume. And we really don't need to know anything about the second reaction in order to determine the volume, since we are given information on how much A is converted and we know its kinetics. So we'll approach this problem by writing a material balance for A. That's shown here for a CSTR reactor. We can do a change of variables here and write this in terms of volumetric flow rates and concentrations. And furthermore, express that change in concentration as conversion. So that change in concentration is basically the definition of conversion times CA naught. So we can bring in our conversion variable. That's equal to the reaction rate times the volume. And that's equal to, based on the fact that this is a elementary reaction, it's equal to the rate constant times the concentration of A times the concentration of B, and again times the volume. The concentration of B in this case is a constant. Now we basically know all the values that we need here except for the volume so that we can solve for it directly. All right, so we're given the inlet concentration of B of 50 moles per liter. All right, that CA is equal to the inlet concentration of A, which is given, times 1 minus X, where X is 80% and the inlet concentration of A is half a mole per liter. We are given the rate constant, K1D, of 0.0043 liters per mole minute. And we're given the volumetric flow rate through the reactor, which is 7.3 liters per minute. And so then we have all of our unknowns specified, and we can solve for a volume, which is equal to 140 liters. Now in part B of this problem, we want to know what the outlet concentration is of F. It makes sense that we'll want to write our mole balance on F, and we should be able to determine how much F we form based on the fact that we know the kinetics and the reactor volume, so we can solve for the molar flow rate of F out of the reactor. And so we'll set up that material balance. It's a very similar form to the one for A, except for we have no inlet flow of F. And we'll go ahead and start plugging in the kinetics, that the rate is equal to the rate constant times the concentration of D times the concentration of B, which is a constant, times the volume. But the issue is that we don't know the concentration of D, and so we'll need to solve for it through a mole balance on D, and so let's do that here, that the flow rate out of D is going to be equal to the rate with which it's formed minus the rate with which it is consumed. We'll write out the flow rate, molar flow rate of D is the total volumetric flow rate times the concentration of D in the exit stream for the reactor, and it's formed through reaction 1. And it's consumed through reaction 2, where 2 moles of D are consumed for every mole of F that are formed. And so we'll need a 2 in front of this rate expression. And we'll solve for the concentration of D. We're given the rate constants for both reactions, but the first and second reaction. As in the first problem, we know the inlet concentration, the concentration of A, which is CA naught times 1 minus X. We know the concentration of the solvent. And now we know the volume from part A. We again know the rate constant, and again the concentration of the solvent as well as the volume. And so our only unknown is the concentration of D, and we can solve for that using a solver function. And so we find that the concentration of D is 0.056 moles per liter. Right, we're at 80% conversion. We can plug in the fact that the concentration of A is 0.10 moles per liter. All right, now we have the information we need to solve the other equation that we wrote for the molar flow rate of F out. And again, that's equal to the volumetric flow rate, total volumetric flow rate times the concentration of F. We know that total volumetric flow rate and we want to solve for C sub F. We again know K2F, we just solved for the concentration of D of 0.056 moles per liter. We know the concentration of B, and in part A we solve for the volume. So our only unknown is the concentration of F exiting the reactor, and we find that it's equal to 0.17 moles per liter. To recap this problem, what we basically have seen is that we're able to solve for the volume given the conversion of one of the reactants that participates in only one reaction. We can do a simple mole balance on that reaction to solve for the volume. And then for the second part of the problem, we wanted to solve for the flow rate out of another product. And in order to do that, we needed information on a product that was involved in both reactions, which required us to take into account both of those reactions and the mole balance.